Drowned Giant is a story by J.G. Ballard. I've always loved this story.
Come on then, Stephen. No time to waste gawking.
I can't explain to you why I love it so much, but part of it is because this drowned giant washes ashore in this town, and there's a lot of conversation about what it means about life and death and the philosophy of our memories and spectacle. But what it never attempts to say is where the giant came from, or how he got here, or what he died from, or any of that. I just loved it, and it stuck with me always.
His magnificent Homeric stature offered a more authentic example of a drowned Argonaut, or a hero from the Odyssey.
I wanted to do it as close to realistic as possible. If it was overly animated, I feel like you would lose that connection of it being something fantastic in the ordinary world. I feel that the story's surreality comes from this implausible creature that shows up in our reality. So I wanted to make the world as real and normal as possible.
There was nothing morbid about this, because for all intents, the giant was still alive for me.
I swore up and down I wouldn't fuck it up. I would do the story justice. And it really is as close as I could make it to Ballard's original vision.
In the end, his face had been transformed into a mask of exhaustion and helplessness. Caught in that same twisting whirlpool for which all our finite lives are destined.
I get very emotional. Ballard wrote me and said her father would have loved it. That means a lot. She went through and said a lot of nice things, but the last one was, yeah, my dad would have loved it.
The giant is still alive for me. I often dream of his resurrection. A colossus striding through the streets of town, picking up the fragments of himself on his return journey to the sea.